This is Rob Bouw, and today in Touch Turbo Talks, we're talking to Shanna Korova from CCC Live about the National Championships in the Giro Rosa. Alright, it's Thursday the 27th of June. We're 2 days out from the Dutch National Championships on the road for the women's race. And with us on the Touch Turbo Talks is Shanna Korova from CCC Live. Shanna, welcome. How are you these days?
Hey, thank you. Yes, I'm fine. I'm preparing for the Nationals road race. Yeah, upcoming Saturday. So it's hot here in the Netherlands. So I'm trying to stay cool, and yeah, I'm looking forward.
I was about to say it's only 2 days away, and there's a bit of a heat wave, maybe a little bit in the Netherlands. How do you think that's going to affect the race on Saturday?
Yeah, for sure it will make it harder. It's not that long this year. It's 120k, but yeah, with the heat, yeah, it's really important to drink really good and stay focused. And yeah, when you can stay focused, yeah, you will have an advantage compared to your opponents. I think so.
Do you have a special plan with the team? How are you gonna stay calm during the race, to getting extra water bottles in, etc.?
I don't know yet, actually, because yeah, tomorrow we will come together and we will make our plan for the race. But yeah, our Swannies will prepare for the heat with extra bidons in the car and alongside the road. It's a it's a lap, so it's easier to get bidons alongside the road. And we will see tomorrow.
I saw actually when I looked into it, to the national championship, and I came across like a funny fact that the last time that your teammate Marianne Vos became national champion, someone else who you know really well was also riding the road race. Do you know who I mean?
Oh, I think I know, my mom, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, really? Oh, that's funny. Yeah,
2011. Because yeah, you come from a big cycling family.
Yeah, that's true.
So how does everyone? How did you get involved in cycling? How did it all went when you grew up?
Yeah, actually, my brother was riding his bike first, and then I followed him a bit, and I started with a race on normal bike for little kids here in my own town. I did a small race, and I won that race. Yeah, it was with school kids, and after that I did a national championship of with normal bike. When you won the small race, you can get to watch the championship, and after that I went to the club and started riding my bike, and also my parents get involved really in it. And my mom, she started really late with cycling, actually, so that's why she was still riding a couple of years ago. And so I went into cycling, and the whole family followed a bit.
So obviously all weekends where all you guys did as a family was just going from race to race at some point.
Yeah, because we were different age. So then, for example, my brother had to race in the south of Netherlands. I had to race in the north. And then we tried to make a plan and that we can go to both. Or yeah, and then sometimes even watch my mom racing. So it was, weekends were race days, and it was cool.
And your brother is still racing as well, I believe. Is he taking part in nationals as well this weekend?
No, he did last weekend with the without contract riders championship.
Oh, okay.
This year my sister is riding also with me in the nationals.
Ah, okay. So is there still a member in the family who doesn't ride a bike or isn't competitive cyclist?
I also have an older sister, and she is not involved in cycling at all.
Oh, so, okay.
It's funny. Yeah.
So for Saturday, obviously you're a team, maybe with with Mariana, obviously, and then with Rihanna Marcus as well. Is it going to be sort of like the three of you, and then see who's going to be in the best position near the end, or is this like a dedicated leader?
No, I think we will try to, yeah, just with open mind, and yeah, we are, yeah, all allowed to race, and then we will see actually who's in the best position. And yeah, I think we really have to ride in the attack, because yeah, there are good sprinters in the Netherlands. So yeah, I think it will will be aggressive race.
It must be
will be good.
Yeah, it must be the most competitive race in national championship anywhere near the world, if you look at all the riders who are there. So yeah, it's probably awesome that you got like a good plan of attack for that. Is there like what's your dream scenario for the race?
Ooh, for me it would be the best to be in a small group on front, and that I would be the strongest. Then that there is from the big teams, every big team has a rider with, so then we can stay away, and yeah, that would be the best. And it would be even better to be together with another teammate in the front group, actually.
And then at the end, it's going to be you who crosses the line first. Is that a bit of a dream? Is something you dream about, or?
Yeah, it's a dream of me. Yeah, definitely. I've never been national champ, so I'm still. I still want it someday. Yeah.
Because if I looked at your results last year, late last year, you got your first victory. Could you describe that feeling that you got when you won that stage in the Belgium Tour, I think?
Yes, that's true. It was crazy, because I attacked, we did actually with the team first a lead out, kind of, like the last 3K. And then I attacked the last kilometer, and I went full gas to the finish, and I made it with... Yeah, I just didn't look back, and I just made it with one wheel, or the peloton was sprinting full gas behind. But then it was just so overwhelming, you know. I never won big race, and I was so grateful for the team. They helped me, and I was just happy to have that victory, because I was riding all the time. Yeah, all the year and season really good, and then you get rewarded, and it made me feel really happy.
How did you go into this season? Did you have like certain goals for yourself in terms of development, or what was it like?
Yes, after last season, I was really motivated to make another step actually this year, and to get more results actually. But till now, I had a bit of I struggled a bit with myself and my shape, and I set some goals, but I had to adjust them a bit. And, for myself, it's really developing myself, to get stronger, but also in the team, like helping my teammates, and but also like in the tactics to develop and learn from my other teammates, and to get really a complete rider in the end.
And then you had that unfortunate crash in the OVO Energy Women's Tour. How's that recovery been for you? Was there a lot of time spending on the Tux Neo?
No, I could go outside actually all the time, and my recovery went quite good, but then I got ill, and that was a bit bad timing, because I also wanted to train again. But last week I felt every day better again, so now I'm fully recovered to race next weekend.
And what's on your program after the nationals?
After the nationals, next week I will go to the Giro Rosa, And after that, I will ride also La Course, and then probably some crits in the Netherlands after that, and then I will will go back in with the team to Prudential Ride London, I think so, and then we will get into the last part of the season already.
So how is it to go to like those biggest races on the women's calendar, basically go to the Giro Rosa and La Tour?
I really look forward to it. Last year it was my first Giro, and actually it was always a dream for me to ride the Giro, and it was such a great experience, like 10 days racing. It's just the longest stage race of the year, and I think everyone is really motivated to go there and to do really a long stage race, and together with the team you go through a lot of emotions, and it's like a big family tour also a bit, and it's just special because it has history, and I like that about it.
And what's going to be your role in this next Giro Rosa for the team?
I will be really helping Ashley Molman. She's really aiming for this Giro, and in the past she proved that she can win this race, and I will help as much as possible before the climbs, and and if there's a more rolling stage or with some attacks where a group can stay away, maybe I will try to to be attentive and go for myself.
And do you already know who your roommate is going to be during those 10 days?
No. No, I don't know.
You may, well, you don't have to obviously state the preference now here on the podcast, but what I know is you came into the professional sport already in 2015. You're still only 22, and I think you are the only one since those 5 years we're still on the team with Mariana. What is the main thing that you've learned from her over the years?
Wow, that's a hard question. But I learned a lot about it, from her. But I also think it was a period in which she also had her setback, and I learned to keep working hard and to stay positive. I really see that in Marianne, and she's so grateful to her teammates, to her team, and it's really something I admire, and that you also want to be really like that, and that's what I learned.
Yeah, that must be pretty cool. And obviously, in that time when you came into the team, you were also in the team with Anna van der Breggen and Pauline Ferrand-Prévot. How do you think you have grown yourself since you came in, maybe as a sort of like a rookie back then to now?
I think I also... I was really shy in the beginning, and now I can express myself really a lot more into the team and say what I think about things, and that's how I develop myself, and also I get a lot more stronger. So it came a bit together, I think so.
And maybe if we continue like in your development, we go to the Tux Turbo Talks fan question of the week, because Anja van Impe wanted to know via Instagram, what race would you like to have on your resume by the end of your career? So which one would you have liked to have won?
Oh, well, that's a nice one. I really like the classics actually in the beginning of the year. So if I put on really high, I would say Tour of Flanders.
Tour of Flanders? Okay, cool. what attracts you in that race? What do you think is the beauty of it that you put it on top of your list?
I think it's just Belgium make it so big, like all the fans and everything. It's so much history, and it's like really, if you can win that race, you are really strong and you have good tactics. I like that. And yeah, you just have to have a big engine. And yeah, I think when you can win that race, you really prove you are, yeah, you are like a really good cyclist. And I think that's why I put it on first. But I like a lot of races, so.
So maybe first this Saturday to get the national championship out of the way, take that one off.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to wrap it up here. Thanks, Janne, for your time. Good luck on Saturday with the team.
Yeah, thank you.
And hopefully we'll see you maybe win Tour of Flanders one day in the red and red, white, blue jersey. That would be the best.
Yeah, that would be great. Yeah. Cool.
All right. Thanks, everyone, for listening. Don't forget to rate, subscribe, review this Dutch Turbo Talks podcast. This was Rob Pauw with Sanne Korevaar from CCC Live. Stay tuned for a new Dutch Turbo Talks next week.